on their quarterback, Dak Prescott. He was ranked as the 18th best quarterback this season by Pro Football Focus. Dak finished in the middle of the pack, 4 TD passes and yards, and he was ranked behind quarterbacks like Kirk Cousins, Dalton, and Matthew Stafford on the list. So Shannon has already kind of made some faces over there.
Good.
Too high, too low, just right for Dak.
So just so for me, because earlier Skip was telling me, Pro Football Focus is made up of Hall of Famers and people that
I didn't say Hall of Famers. I said NFL Connection.
And what did they do, Skip?
Yeah.
They study tape all the time.
Yeah, unlike play you. Play to play to play.
So they,
they break down every play
every
of 16
play.
Games.
So who am I to disagree with them?
Yeah.
Yeah, you told me.
You've already disagreed with them twice.
Oh,
you said it was bogus.
Oh, no.
You said it was pro football foolishness.
You told me, say, are you saying Pro Football Focus said for pro football foolishness?
Mm-hmm.
I said, Skip, I wouldn't go that far. You like, nope, dude, you better not say that. So now you want me to go against everything.
I don't know. What do you think? You're the Hall of Famer.
Oh, I think, I think it's just about right.
About right?
Yeah, just about right. I think, you know, if you look at, stats. You love stats, Skip. 19th in yards per attempt, Dink it and Dak it. 21st in yards per game. 16th in touchdown passes.
Yeah.
What are they? They got him at 18th. 18th, not 21st, 16th.
Yeah.
That's 18 to me. I don't know how you get around that, Skip Bayless.
Because
let's see. 21, 40. Yeah, oh, yeah, that 19.
So now you like pro football food.
Hold on, Skip Bayless. Hold on. 21st, 19.
Yeah.
That's 40, 16, 56. So 56, 3 into 56. Oh, that's right. That's about right, Skip. That's about right. 18. 18 about right. That's about right. I can't complain. Hold on. See, you see the thing is, if they broke down the game like you say they did. Now, you tell me that all they do is sit around and break down tape and watch game. So they got a lot of time.
They don't sit around. They sit up on the edge of the chair, man.
They run it back. Let's look at the footwork.
Back and forth and back and forth.
Like you tell me, Skip, I ain't got that kind of time. But anyway, let me tell you what I did do. I looked at this game. He scored 0 points against the Colts. Intentionally, 16 games, a big sample size. That's what Skip tell me. He said, Shannon, 16 games. You're the Pro Football Hall of Famer. Is 16 games a lot of games? I said, Skip, that's a lot of games. That's a large sample size. That's what you tell me. In 10 of his 16 games, Dak Prescott threw 1 or 0 touchdowns. I don't know how you get outside the middle of the pack with that. He also holds on to the ball.
I agree.
He was the second most sacked quarterback in all of football.
To Deshaun Watson.
Skip, I mean, I'm gonna give him kudos because I thought at the halfway point, Skip, he was below average. At least they got him in that middle tier. He's somewhere average. So with that being said, you know, 18 seems about
good. Good. I'm glad you agreed because I also agree with Pro Football Focus. His season should rank 18th. We can say either best or worst. Maybe you say 18th worst this year. That's play to play to play for 16 games.
What?
Because the first 8 games were not good for Dak Prescott. Why did that happen? The first 8 games, he had nobody who could consistently separate at the wide receiver position. He had nobody you could even name at tight end, right? Because you didn't even know who these people were.
Nope.
And I kept saying, well, there is that guy from Baylor, the basketball player. Remember that guy?
Whatever happened to Rico?
I don't know what happened to Rico, but he couldn't play football, and he's out. He's on the team still, but he's out. He has had no impact. Blake Jarwin started to come alive here the last couple of games.
And what's the other guy?
Yeah. Jeff Swain.
Yeah. He got injured.
Yeah, he got hurt, and he's still hurt. Broke his wrist. So he's had nobody to throw to. He had Tavon Austin. You said he's just a gadget guy.
Just
a gadget guy. And he had him for a little while, and then he got hurt against Jacksonville at Jerry World, and that was the end of him, and he has just come back now. So he didn't even have that. And going into the season, he lost his leader of the offensive line, his Pro Bowl center, Travis Frederick, right? Gone.
Yes.
And he's been gone for the whole year, and it does. I got to knock on wood for him because that's a rough one. And our Mark Schlereth has gone through this, and he said, boy, I think it's going to take a while, and it looks like it's going to take a long while. Okay, so you're down there. So your degree of difficulty has gone through the roof because you have nobody to consistently throw to, and you got new receivers in Deontay Thompson, who's no longer on the team, and Allen Hurns, who had a moment here and a moment there, but the kid Michael Gallup, he was still just a rookie. Now he's coming along. So for the first 8 games, and again, they all counted, they dragged you way down. In fact, if you just rank the first 8 games, Pro Football Focus, he'd probably be way down the 25th, 27th,
easy.
Somewhere easily. Maybe 30th. But then all of a sudden, you start to rank the last eight games. Mm. And you start to pull back up. Because over the last eight games, if we had Pro Football, just break down Pro Football Focus, not foolishness, Focus, break down the last eight, he would be a top five.
No, he wouldn't.
Yes,
stop
performer,
it.
Performer. Well, I just told you, over the last eight games, he had the third most completions of anybody in Pro Football. He had the fourth highest passing yards of anybody in Pro Football. And he had the third highest completion percentage. Of all the quarterbacks who played over the last eight games of the season, Dak went third, third, and fourth in those pivotal categories, right? And he had 12 touchdowns, only three interceptions. That's pretty great. I could make a case he might have been the best performer over the last eight games. You could undo it, but you could certainly make a credible case that he was the best quarterback in pro football, and they won seven out of eight of those games.
Because if you wanted to be credible, you wouldn't attempt to make that case that Dak was the best quarterback.
Well, I don't know. Those are high marks in every category.
All up. So if you don't mind me asking, what am I supposed to do with these 10 games in which you threw one touchdown or zero touchdowns? What am I supposed to do with that?
Well, a lot of times maybe Zeke's getting it in from 2 yards or 3 yards. I don't know. But in the 10 wins this year for the Dallas Cowboys, all I know is he threw 17 touchdowns to two interceptions, and that is good.
Well, think about this, Skip.
All right?
In a league that's built on scoring, everybody wants to be Madden.
Yeah.
How do you score 0 points? Mm. If you can answer me that, how do you score 0 points?
Well,
if you're that guy, you got a Coop, and you got Zeke Elliott. Right? Zero.
So help me out, Mr. Hall of Famer.
Yep.
Just 3 weeks ago, the guy that you said should have replaced Tom Brady as the Pro Bowl quarterback, his name is Andrew Luck, went to Jacksonville against what's left of the Jaguars and scored 0 points. Yep. How do you do that, Andrew Luck? Because Andrew Luck's in a whole nother league from Dak Prescott, right?
Yeah.
How did that happen? You lost 6-0?
Six to nothing.
Explain that to me, because I'm lost on that one. I don't know how it happened. How did you do that?
I
don't know. It happens?
But
so does that mean you shouldn't have been on the Pro Bowl team? I don't know.
You see what I'm talking about, Skip?
Okay, well, I'm asking you to explain. You can't explain.
Let me see. If I were to do this, I'm think, would Dak, would Andrew Luck be 21st in yards passing for a game? Would he be, I think he'd be second.
Well, you asked me how Dak scored zero in a game. And that was the same quarterback who just the week before had scored zero in a game.
No, that was 2 weeks before. But anyway, hold on. I don't think Andrew Luck has had 10 games where you scored one or zero touchdown. Mm. Not when you got 39. Mm. Andrew Luck had a span in which he had more touchdowns in eight games than Dak Prescott had for the entire season. Mm. What am I supposed to do with that skill?
Well, what am I supposed to do with 10 wins, 17 touchdowns to two interceptions, averaging 262 yards passing, and have a higher yards per attempt than Andrew Luck?
If you don't mind,
Andrew Luck has turned into a dink and dunker. You realize that?
How many games did the Colts win?
Mm.
10.
Yeah. Okay.
It's not my fault that guess what? That the Houston Texans were 12-4.
Mm. Okay. So 10 wins for Dak Prescott, 17-2 in interceptions, 6 losses. 5-6 interceptions, 5 touchdowns, 6. So again, QBR of 71 in the wins, QBR of 30 in the losses. So he's been a different guy in the 7 out of 8 streak, right?
But my guy, Andrew Luck, my guy now, has a higher QBR, has a higher passer rating, threw for more touchdowns, has more passing yards, and his record is just as good as your guy.
I liked your guy, Andrew Luck.
No, don't like him. I don't want you to like him.
Well, all of a sudden, they drafted two stud rookies at guard and tackle.
Hold on.
Yeah.
You ain't have no problem when y'all drafted like that.
I'm saying.
Zach Martin. What round did Zach Martin go in?
And help me out. Who has, again, higher yards per attempt? Is it Dak or Luck? Dak.
My guy.
By far.
Hold on.
How do you explain that?
My guy missed the whole season.
So Andrew Luck
missed the whole season.
So you got a new guy named Frank Reich as your head coach, and he's teaching him to dink and dack. Right?
What
Andrew Luck is just dinking and dacking.
His shoulder was messed up. My guy missed the whole year.
Really?
And came back and finished. Going to be comeback player.
I love how you jump on these bandwagons.
Don't worry about
it. I stay on my bandwagon. I don't get off. I just stay right there.
That's why I like
it.
So when your bus breaks down, I want you to stay broke down side the road with
it. Some more bandwagons to jump on. Guys, we have a special guest.
Yes, we do.
Coming out right now, Nick Cannon.
Uh-oh.
Live in studio with us.
I like that.
We'll talk to you.